Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, let's see how to group and filter items in the Blazor Dropdown List component. Look at this example, you can see the dropdown list displaying different vegetable names. These vegetables are grouped under different categories like leafy and salad, beans, and bulb and stem. You can also filter the items for ones that match your typed-in characters. I will show you how to group and filter the drop-down list items using the existing Blazor application. Here, I have added the Blazor drop-down list with basic properties. I have bound vegetable names as the data source. Follow the link provided in the card to learn the basics of adding a Blazor drop-down list. You can also find a reference link in the description below. Now, I will run this example by pressing F5. So you can see the drop-down list showing vegetable names. Now, let me show you the steps to group these drop-down list items. First, I will modify the existing data source by defining one more field, category with appropriate values. Then, I will map this data source field to the group by option within the drop-down list field settings tag. When you look at the drop-down list, the data items are grouped under the categories leafy and salad, beans, bulb and stem. Next, I am going to show you how to filter the data items in the drop-down list based on the characters I type in the search box. To start filtering the data items, first, I need to enable the filtering feature in the drop-down. Let me define the property allow filtering and set its value as true inside the drop-down list code. Look at the drop-down list now. When I start to type in characters here, you can see the pop-up displaying the vegetable names that start with my typed-in text. You can see, by default, the casing of the typed-in characters is ignored during the filtering action. But if I wanted the casing considered as I type, then I need to set false to the ignore case property. So you can see, when I start to type characters in lowercase, the drop-down list has no records due to the casing mismatch. Next, let's look at the filter types. By default, the starts with filter type is applied while filtering the data items on dropdown. But you can also filter the list items based on two other types, ends with or contains. Now, I will filter the items based on the end characters of data items by defining the property filter type and setting its value to ends with inside the dropdown list code. And now, if I type in some characters here, you can see the pop-up showing vegetable names that end with my typed-in characters. Similarly, you can also apply the contains filter type if you want to filter for data items that contain your typed-in characters in any position. In this video, we have seen how to group and filter the Blazor drop-down list items. If you would like to see the working example of the drop-down list in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.